Laudetur Jesus Christus. Praised be Jesus Christ. Welcome to this live broadcast from St. Peter's Square on this Sunday, which is the first Sunday of Lent. In just a few moments, Pope Francis will come to the window of the Apostolic Palace, and he will greet us before praying the traditional Angelus at noon, in which we commemorate the conception of God's own Son in the womb of the Blessed Virgin Mary. From wherever you are joining us, I would like to welcome you to this live broadcast. Some of you may be joining us through various Vatican media channels, perhaps the Vatican News app or the Radio Vaticana app, the Vatican News web portal, or the Vatican News English YouTube channel, or on our Facebook Live feed. A special welcome to all of you joining us through our partner broadcasting stations, which include Catholic TV, Catholic Faith Network, Shalom World Television Networks USA, Salt and Light TV, EWTN TV, Radio Maria England, Shalom TV India, Admadarshan TV in India, UCTV, Uganda Catholic Television, and Luminous Radio in India. We also welcome all of you who are joining us through radio stations or other internet sites throughout the world. A very warm welcome to you all. And a special welcome to those of you joining us through our dedicated American Sign Language broadcast, which is made possible with the help of our friends at the Deaf Catholic Youth Initiative for the Americas. My name is Devin Watkins, and I will be providing the commentary and translation for this Angelus. As we await Pope Francis to come to the window and greet us, we note that after this engagement, Pope Francis and the members, heads of dicasteries of the Roman Curia, will take the entire week off for a week of spiritual exercises during this Lent. So Pope Francis invited all of the heads of dicasteries, all of the cardinals who reside in Rome, and all of the superiors of the Roman Curia to take this week of prayer. His own engagements are suspended throughout this week, and this includes the general audience, which usually takes place on Wednesday morning. And so Pope Francis's next public event will be next Sunday's Angelus prayer. We recall that this is the first Sunday of Lent, and last Wednesday, Pope Francis celebrated the Ash Wednesday Mass along with Catholics throughout the world. And as we received ashes to mark our entry into Lent, into the desert. And it's in a time, as the Pope reminded us on that occasion, to go to our inner room and to pray. And we hear the crowds cheering as Pope Francis greets us from the window.
Cari fratelli e sorelle, buongiorno.
Dear brothers and sisters, buongiorno, good morning.
Prima domenica di Quaresima, il Vangelo ci presenta Gesù tentato nel deserto.
Today, on the first Sunday of Lent, the Gospel presents us with Jesus tempted in the desert. The text says he was in the wilderness 40 days, tempted by Satan. We too, during Lent, are invited to enter the wilderness, that is, silence, our inner chamber, listening to the heart, in contact with the truth. In the desert, today's Gospel adds, Christ was with the wild beasts, and the angels ministered to him. Wild beasts and angels were his company. But in a symbolic sense, they are our company too. Indeed, when we enter the inner wilderness, we can encounter wild beasts and angels there.
Bestie selvatiche, in che senso?
Wild beasts, in what sense? In the spiritual life, we can think of them as the disordered passions that divide our heart, trying to take possession of it. They entice us They seem seductive, but if we are not careful, we risk being torn apart by them. We can give a name to these beasts of the soul. The various vices, the lust for wealth, which imprisons us in connivance and dissatisfaction, the vanity of pleasure, which condemns us to restlessness and solitude, and the craving for fame, which gives rise to insecurity and a continuous need for confirmation and prominence. This is interesting. We should not forget these things that we can find inside. Vanity and avidity. They are wild beasts, and as such, they must be tamed and fought. Otherwise, they will devour our freedom. We need to go into the wilderness to become aware of their presence and to face them. And then the angels. These are God's messengers who help us, who do us good. Indeed, their characteristic, according to the Gospel, is service, the exact opposite of possession, typical of the passions we spoke about earlier. They serve against possession. The angelic spirits instead recall the good thoughts and sentiments suggested by the Holy Spirit. While temptations tear us apart, the good divine inspirations unify us in harmony. They quench the heart, infuse the taste of Christ, the flavor of heaven. And here, too, to grasp the thoughts and feelings inspired by God, we must be silent and enter into prayer. And Lent is the time to do this. As we take our first steps on the Lenten path, let us ask ourselves two questions. First of all, what are the disordered passions, the wild beasts that agitate my heart? And second, to permit the voice of God to speak to my heart and to preserve it in goodness, am I thinking of retreating a little into the wilderness, that is, of dedicating space to silence, prayer, and listening to the Word of God? May the Holy Virgin, who kept the Word and did not let herself be touched by the temptations of the evil one, help us on our way during this time of Lent.
Domine non sia vid Maria.
Et concepite Spiritus Sancto.
Ave Maria, grazia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tui mulieribus e benedictus fructus ventris tui, Iesus.
Sancta Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostre. Amen.
Ciancilla Domini.
Fiat mi secundum verbum tuum.
Ave Maria, grazia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tui mulieribus e benedictus fructus ventris tui, Iesus.
Sancta Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostre. Amen.
Et verbum caro factum est.
Et habitavit in nobis.
Ave Maria, gratia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tui mulieribus, et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Iesus.
Sancta Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostre. Amen.
Ora pro nobis, Santa Dei Genitris.
Ut dignificamur promissionibus Christi.
Gratiam Tua, quesum Domine, mentibus nostris infunde, qui angelo nunciante, Christi Fili Tua, incarnazione coniovim, per passionem eius ad crucem, a resurrezione gloriam perducamur, per Christum Dominum nostrum.
Amen.
Gloria Patri et Filio et Spiritui Santo.
Sicut erat in principio, et nunc et semper, et in saecula saeculorum. Amen.
Pro fideibus defuntis, regim aeterna dona eis Domine.
Et lux perpetua luceat eis.
Requiescant in pace.
Amen.
Sit nomen Domini benedictum.
Ex hoc nunc et usque in saeculum.
Aiutorium nostrum in nomine Domini.
Qui feci caelum et terra.
Benedicat vos, omnipotens Deus, Pater et Filius, et Spiritus Sanctus. Amen. Amen. Cari fratelli e sorelle,
dear brothers and sisters, 10 months have already passed since the outbreak of the conflict in Sudan, which has created a grave humanitarian crisis. I invite all of those involved to stop this war, which hurts so much this country. May paths toward peace be found quickly to help the people of Sudan. The destruction of infrastructure, the harm against innocent civilians, and other problems in the Cabo Delgado region of Mozambique, Catholic mission in the Abruzzese was damaged, or was attacked. There are so many. Please stop these many conflicts that tear apart several countries in Africa and Ukraine and the Holy Land. War, let's never forget, is always a defeat. People are tired of war. It's always useless, never brings anything but destruction and death. It will never bring a proper solution. Let us pray for peace without tiring, because prayer is efficacious, it works. And remember, let us dedicate our hearts entirely to peace. I also greet the pilgrims from other parts of the world and from Italy, especially those who come from the United States of America, the neo-catechumenal movement from the Czech Republic, Slovakia and Spain, the alumni of the Colorado School, and from the servants of the world, and I greet all of the farmers and ranchers who are present in the square. This afternoon, together with my collaborators in the Curia, we'll begin our spiritual exercises. I invite this community to unite yourselves in prayer with us, as we may continue during this year of prayer dedicated to preparing for the Jubilee of 2025. And I wish all of you a good Sunday, and please do not forget to pray for me. Have a good lunch, and arrivederci. And with that, we end this live broadcast of the recitation of the Noonday Angelus with Pope Francis here in St. Peter's Square on the first Sunday of Lent. Please visit the Vatican News web portal, our Facebook, Instagram, X, and YouTube accounts for coverage of today's Angelus, as well as other Vatican and world news. We will be back again live on next Sunday, when Pope Francis will lead the Angelus in St. Peter's Square. On behalf of Vatican Media, I would like to thank our in-studio audio engineer, Adriano Vitali, and our audio coordinator, Jean-Charles Puzzulli, and all of our media partners on TV and radio, as well as our friends at DYCIA who have made this broadcast possible in American Sign Language, and to all of you for joining us. My name is Devin Watkins. I wish you a blessed Sunday. Laudetur Jesus Christus. Praise be Jesus Christ.